Yo, what's happening everyone? Welcome back to another video. So today we have got the Mini Clubman back on the channel. So part two is here, stay tuned and we get to it.
She cut too deep, now she left me scarred. Now there's so many thoughts going through my brain, and now I'm taking these shots like it's Novocaine. Yeah. Ooh, I fall apart down to my
here we are out in the Mini Clubman, owned by Jamie, who's Hello. One of my best mates. We're going to go through a few bits, what he likes, what he dislikes, what his plans are with the car. And yeah, stay tuned and we will go through it. Salted bell. Fuck me, it's cold out there, I tell you. Yeah, pretty skinny. So how long have you owned the car now, Jamie?
4 months.
4 months.
Yeah. I actually quite like it.
Yeah, you like it?
Might have rushed a bit, but I didn't need a lot. I kind of needed a bigger car.
Yeah. Well, before this, you had the John Conqueror Works.
No, I just had the Cooper S.
Oh, the Cooper S. Oh, okay. Yeah.
It's quite modified, that one.
Yeah, what year was that one?
2015.
2015?
Yeah.
Okay, so, yeah. Got a brand new one. 20 plate, this one is. So, you liking it?
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah.
It's comfortable, it's quick.
More practical?
More practical, definitely.
The reason Jamie got this one is because he wanted more room because he's got a child seat in the back and he couldn't get his boy about as easy, so he wanted a bit more room. I'd say more comfort, but you put KW Corlos on it. Yeah. What they like?
Better than the standard suspension. The original suspension was so horrible.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's too stiff. It just didn't react very well to small bumps.
Oh, okay.
KW is just so comfy.
Yeah.
It don't really get much body roll.
Right.
The car comes sky high, it's literally a 4x4.
Yeah, I mean, I did go out in it previous with them. I mean, I haven't driven this, so I don't know what it's like, but it looks and it sits so much better.
Like, yeah, I don't mainly for the looks.
Yeah.
But I'm worried that coilovers would be quite clashy, but they're actually, it's the first set of expensive coilovers.
I mean, me being in this, it doesn't feel too, like, harsh.
No.
Because I've had cheap coilovers, and I've had... Okay, and sometimes you get that ride, it's so much more stiff, isn't it? Like a bit,
yeah, and it clashes, damping, it's crap.
But yeah, shout out to them, they actually feel quite nice.
It's worth the wait.
If you haven't already seen, on the previous video, we fitted the KW coilovers, so go have a little look. If you like the video, like, share, subscribe, you know the score. Not my car, but I mean, I'm not a fan of the red roof, but that's me. That's,
I think it's quite common for John Cooper Works to have red roofs, and I sort of want to get rid of it.
I did see a one of these,
it's all blacked out,
and it looked nice, yeah.
So, yeah, I'll probably go that route, just a few little bits like that, and then when the warranty is probably gone or nearly up, I'll get it mapped.
Get it mapped, yeah. Well, you got a panel filter or induction?
Yeah, just the panel filter now.
Panel filter,
Across one. That is it. I'm probably going to get a back box for IPF filter back.
Yeah.
Because I don't want to mess with that.
They're the ones with the valves? Or?
Yeah, it's valved at the moment, but it's not a lot of difference in noise.
Right.
So I think the one I'll probably get would be the Cobra one. It comes with like carbon fibre tips, right. Carbon fibre look tips.
Sometimes. Mate, it sounds nice. When we done a little few flyby shots a little while ago, and sounds naughty. Like, it's underestimated, I think. Like,
yeah.
If you saw this on the road, not everybody's going to know sort of what it's capable of. I think, what are these, 4.7 0 to 60?
Yeah.
It's literally ridiculous.
Yeah, I've surprised a few people.
Yeah, I think they're running the same engine as the BMW M135.
Yeah.
So.
And the same engine as the GP gearbox, obviously. The GP is so stripped out of that.
That's what I'm saying. People see these on the road, they're not. I don't know, they're underestimated. It's a bit of a family wagon / enjoyment toy as well, isn't it? So you can use it for every day. It's nice. Seats are nice. It's comfortable.
Yeah.
I like it.
Because
I bring up a little spec sheet because I wasn't too sure about these. And there was a video online with one of these, and I think it was 230. And I was thinking, hold up a minute, I've just read that it's 306 or something like that.
Even some dealers get it wrong.
Yeah, it was literally the older shape of this. It looks very similar, but the engines in them are the older ones, which only produce like 230 or something. So, like, they're proper up there, guys.
For once, normally there's not a lot of difference.
Yeah.
You just get the caliper seats and whatever, not a lot for your money.
Yeah.
But now they've actually made it more worthwhile to spend a bit extra to get
it. Makes it more attractive for someone who wants that extra power.
But it's still quite boring looking on the outside, nothing special. But
I think it's nice, to be fair. It's very wide.
Yeah.
I mean, what did you put on there? 10 mil spaces?
Yeah, I've got 10 mil spaces.
10 mil spaces all around. You've also got the flappy paddles.
Yeah, it's got the flap paddle extensions. Yeah. Ones are a bit small.
They look pretty smart, to be fair.
Yeah, very nice. Stick on, £70. Yeah. Lovely.
Very nice. £70?
Yeah. It's bargain. Yeah, it's bad. I was going to get black ones. I thought we'd get red. It got red stitching everywhere, so goes well with that.
That's fair. This guy has literally got me in debt, really, because last year we were saying, like, let's do the Nürburgring, let's all go down there in September, and we was like, yeah, okay, let's do this. So Cookie brought the previous Mini, what was it, Mini Cooper S, wasn't it? Yeah, Mini Cooper S. Our mate Stu's got a Mini Cooper S as well, and then I brought a Focus ST 225, and was in the process of doing bits. And then the missus smashed that up, so scrapped that. Then I think I brought a Fiesta ST180, which was running 330 brake, which was good, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That thing was savage.
Didn't handle.
These guys still kept their cars, still doing bits. And I sort of brought one already done, really. And then COVID hit. And then, it just screwed up our plans, really.
That ain't really my fault, then.
No, I suppose. But from me buying these cars and then doing bits to them, it's just got me in a little bit of...
Not
debt, but it's just made my bank balance go. But next year is going to be the one we're all planning to go there. There's going to be a few interesting things to see to come. So stay tuned on that front. So keep your eyes peeled. We're going to go for a little launch.
Yeah.
Get
it all in. Pain in the ass to get going. So.
Right.
But it'll never
driving, like say B roads, and you wanted to have a little bit of a blitz, how do you find it going through the gears on the paddles?
Fine now.
All right.
It was weird at first. You can do it on the gear stick as well, like up and down.
Yeah.
But yeah, it just takes a while because
it's still enjoyable.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You don't feel like you're going as quick because obviously you're not doing a lot of input on the manual. You're changing gears.
I know, and that's the thing. You feel like you're more part of the car changing gear, don't you? And it's like enjoyable going through gears changing and etc. But yeah, on going on to paddles, I think they take me a bit of adjustment.
Yeah.
I think the Golf R's, a lot of them are.
Yeah, you can get a manual version. They do a manual version for Golf R, but mainly a DSG.
Yeah.
It's not really, obviously, what I don't really drive as cars because they take a lot of connection away. But
yeah.
I don't think I'd go back to a manual again.
No?
No, just because how chilled you can drive it. You don't, with a manual, you got a quickie sort of manual car.
Yeah.
You do.
See, I don't think I could convert. I feel like have a family car, which your everyday car, automatic, all day long. Because it's just easy in traffic. You're not going to be, I don't feel like I'm going to be going crazy in such as that. Do you know what I mean? But I feel like for me, as a toy, I think I'd want a manual.
I think if I got, I did get a toy, but yeah, I don't think it's that cheap. Probably, I don't know, clear 182.
But you've got the best of both worlds, haven't you? You've got like a 306 brake horsepower Mini Clubman, which is practical to take the kids out in.
Yeah.
It looks presentable, and it gives you the joy, like your thrills, doesn't it? Like,
yeah, I do get quite a lot of fun.
And it's comfortable.
Yeah.
I mean, that launch is... it's something else. So I've been in Mate's RS3 and that launches, but it launches in a different, it's a weird different sensation. Yeah. It's strange, yeah.
I've never been in a car of launch control before, did.
Yeah, this one definitely is up there.
They say it's sort of 4.7. I don't know, obviously I've never thought through it, but
yeah. That's quick.
It is quick. You look at what other some cars are doing.
That's the thing, it's the worst weather as well, isn't it? It does pick up well.
Doesn't it? You've got to be in the right gear, like.
Have you?
Yeah, and manual. If you're in auto, it's. The kick down here will kick down like three gears if you're in fifth or whatever.
What, if you're in auto?
They'll avoid it for the kick down in auto.
Oh, okay.
You think you're in the right gear and then you press like go down to overboost and then kick down another gear.
Okay.
It's a bit embarrassing.
It's a bit slow.
Yeah. I mean, it's quick, but then.
So if you want to drive it fast, make sure you're in manual.
Yeah, you get the most enjoyment out of better gear change.
The road is like
shiny.
It's that dirty weather where it's like you don't want to be. Yeah, you know you're gonna slip, like. But that it sticks. I felt a little bit.
It does twitch a bit from the front. It does wash out a bit on the front.
Does it?
Because it's not always not permanent four wheel drive. It's predominantly front and then.
And it's intelligent four wheel drive.
Yeah.
Is it?
The best thing to say is like that. Is it a Howlick system on the Golf R's?
Right.
Because they're predominantly front and then it'll kick power to the rear when needed.
Okay.
Stage one's literally just filled right now.
Have you looked into stage one?
I've seen a bit, but I don't think many have been mapped. I think Motec, Philip on Motec, they do tuning. But
I wonder if you can compare it to the M135i.
I have looked, but then it's the older model.
But then I think they have bigger torque. I don't know what the torque level is on this. I think they're a little bit less, but
I think
obviously they're going to down tune it somewhere, aren't they? But
I think the BMW on paper they've put it down a little slightly quicker.
Right. So what figures would they give you on a stage one?
To be honest, I actually wouldn't know. I'd hope, personally, I'd hope for like 340.
Oh, I think that's achievable. It's got to be achievable, isn't it?
I've seen like tuning boxes, which I don't really want to get, but I've seen someone have about, I think it was 348, I think.
348, yeah. Mate, 348 would be alright, I reckon. Yeah. That'd be very, very capable.
The torque goes up to 500.
For being out and how it's driven, like. Another 50 brake horsepower in this would probably be pretty much of an animal, wouldn't it?
Yeah, the gearboxes can't really take much more than 500 torque, apparently.
Can they not? Well, that's big enough, though, isn't it? There's no point chasing figures sometimes.
No, I've never really been in my other car and got stage one just to prove it.
Yeah, just getting to a happy medium. So that's pretty much it, really, guys. I mean, thank you, Jamie, for bringing it on the channel. Any future mods, what's going to come this way, like if he does the stage one on it and stuff like that, we'll get it back on the channel so you guys can have a little look and see what it's saying. Yeah, if you like the video, please like, share, subscribe, like it all helps, and yeah, thank you.